There's many reasons, because I've been talking about Tai Chi and yoga in schools and different places. I think it's so important at this stage in the world when there's so much stress and so much everything else, and that people need their own tools to be able to have an equipment so that they're happy in their body and they have something that's helping them to be healthy, fit, breathing well, feel happy and free in their space and confident in themselves. And I think that's really important. So I'm really hoping to get yoga and Tai Chi, if we could get it out into the schools, to do all kinds of sports. This would be an equipment for life. Doesn't matter. You know, there's a horrible thing when exams are on, they stop doing exercise. Isn't it the craziest thing? It's the time when they really need to be doing it. And afterwards, for sport, you know, it stops you getting sport injuries. It means you're always at a level of fitness, and then you can add on your extra training to it. And the flexibility it gives for that, for having babies, whatever it is, you know your body, you know how it breathes. And for people as they get older, just the flexibility in the joints. So many people, older people, sprain. They twist in their ankle, and because it's stiff, they get a strain. So I really think it would be wonderful to get that information out there. But there's one even more important reason, I think. We've just come back from the United Nations, the President and I, and a big feature is for 2015 is that we've tried to end global poverty or do it. And the other thing is that women, the importance of women, if the world is get to be a peaceful place. So the United Nations women, there's the climate change as well. That is a big occasion this year. And United Nations women is that there will be equality for women by 2030, which is 15 years' time. And all the countries of the United Nations have signed up to bringing in the legislation. They did it in Beijing in 20 years ago, and a lot of legislation came in that helped women. So in this year, they're signing up to it. There'll be more legislation in it. But the big, big problem all over the world, everybody came and spoke about it from, you know, South America, Central America, Africa, Europe, Ireland, everywhere. Big problem is gender violence and domestic violence. It's wrecking the world physically and economically. And it is so prevalent. And really, and domestic violence, we've been to Pamela and I down the country, we're just amazed at the rise in domestic violence in Ireland. Now, I think there's frustration. Things that go wrong, full of stress. So who do you let it out on? The people who love you most. It's an own goal going back into your home and doing this. But people are frustrated. They don't know what to do. And I feel that if they have the tool of their body working well, of them breathing well, their fitness, they're able to take the shocks. That's one of the great things I found about yoga. Even when I was in Dublin in 1974, when all the car bombs were going on, when you were doing yoga or Tai Chi, the body will fill up. It's working so well, it will just fill up with breath and be able to take the shock. And I think if young people, if men particularly, because he for she is a big feature of this, yeah. But if it were part of our school or could get it being done, people would be able to deal with the stresses and cope with it. They would have the tools. So that's, I'm probably going on a little, but I do think it could make for a lot better ability of people to be confident and cope with them, and particularly even with young women, all this, you know, online bullying, all those kind of things, just to have the ability to take the shocks and be able to see it. So that's all I want to say, that I am so, so happy to know that so many people are, you know, doing it and benefiting from it. And I think it's a really wonderful thing. So maybe next year we'll have another day. But now I'd like you to hand over to Cliche.
think I'll pick up on the energy and the forcefulness of Sabina there, and this remarkable opportunity, which this is unexpected. That's key. that was me and two hot whiskeys last night up above. We wouldn't want to lose that now. We have this remarkable opportunity that our president, wild man Michael D. himself here, to address what we actually think and feel. I know a few people out there. There's Kevin Moran, who probably is going to curse me that I mentioned his name, from the Dundalk Youth Centre. There's Tom Connolly, a poet and educator, passionately involved with children. Is it Catherine McNamara, who I haven't met, other than saying hello, who's been working in Derry for 16 years, a Tai Chi project with old people. There's enormous resources in this room, and this is unexpected. We have an opportunity to state our case for moving forward, rather than just a nice day in the Áras and a bit of free grub and a glass of wine. I'd like to quote from what I consider one of the great texts of the last century, from T.S. Eliot, from Four Quartets. And anyone who knows about Tai Chi knows that if we were to get its full range, we'd be talking about its philosophy, self-defense, and the health. For me, self-defense is not just about push hands and its element within the martial arts, as important, as interesting as that is. Self-defense in our times is closer to how we're addressing each other, how we behave better together, how we address what's happening to the earth, the conference that'll be happening in Paris at the end of November about climate change, that all the issues, how do we constructively use what we know about Tai Chi as a resource for entering creatively and imaginatively in the political arena. I think we have a lot we can help with, if we can add with thinkers and political people, social activists, to use the skills that we know that there is something fundamentally connected with how the body and the mind are connected. And we realize that there's a connection there. The foolishness that we hear every day in the Dáil of all these grown men arguing with each other, inability to listen to each other, to quietly accept that someone might have something to say just because they're from another party. The foolishness, I'm independent, the foolishness of seeing something in the paper last week of the Minister of Health or Minister of Finance suggesting that what we need is to give iPads to every five-year-old in the country. Anyone who knows about education realizes that's a recipe for disaster to a generation that's increasingly addicted to screens and visions that are in front of their eyes. That we are in incredibly complex times. And I think the Tai Chi can open us to engaging in the times that we're living in. To me, that's part of the tradition of Tai Chi, is to move things forward, to learn from the past, but also to realize where we are. We're in Ireland, we're here, we have something else to offer, yet honoring the wonderful tradition that has been passed on to us and the blessings that have come forward from us. The reason for bringing up T.S. Eliot, for me, the starting point with self-defense or health is an aspect of stillness and centering. I live in Dundalk, and one of the projects I work with is called the Dundalk Youth Center. And a couple of summers ago, I was walking past and I saw the sign, Dundalk Youth Center. I looked at it and I thought, what it should say is Dundalk Youth, comma, Center, exclamation point. And that's not just the challenge being older to young people, that's an address to myself as well. How do we not be caught in the whirlwind of Netflix and all the crap that's being thrown at us all the time? How do we find an authentic center, acting from that, living from that, behaving from that, thinking from that, and imaginatively engaging from that center? To me, that is what I think Tai Chi has opened me up for the last 40 years. I'll just be brief because there's other people. I used to work in Portlaoise prison back in the 90s when the peace process was being debated. And what I found fascinating in a hothouse like Portlaoise prison was that there was tremendous interest in both yoga more than Tai Chi, but lots of the prisoners were doing Tai Chi and they were doing yoga. And because they realized that they needed to find some inner direction to center themselves to how to live in that situation. But interestingly enough, many of the people who were doing Tai Chi and yoga also instinctively felt they needed to write or paint. In other words, when the body releases some of the tensions, it has to express itself in some manner. And it was funny, by instinctively, like I said, they began to paint or to write. So there was something about centering the energies, there was something about expression, but then there was also discussion about they had been through various phases of violence, was looking how do you still work towards change but without physical violence. So to me there was something interesting how in what could be considered hardcore in a prison, instinctively recognized that Tai Chi and yoga were fundamental. And I think Sabina's really onto something by linking those two disciplines together. So I just want to say that, and everything I planned isn't here. That was just the Holy Spirit moving through me, hopefully, appropriately. So I'll close with some beautiful passage from T.S. Eliot. And if you haven't read Four Quartets, it is one of the most stunning texts about the importance of stillness. And I'm going to just read something. It's very brief. And then please have the courage to come up and speak. At the still point of the turning world, neither flesh nor fleshless, neither from nor towards, at the still point, there the dance is, but neither arrest nor movement, and do not call it fixity, where past and future are gathered, neither movement from nor towards, neither ascent nor decline, except for the point, the still point. There would be no dance, no Tai Chi, and there is only the dance. And one other brief passage, I'm out of here. I said earlier with the warm-ups, to me the hardest movement is still the first one, to do nothing before you do something. And also the transition from one movement to the other. To me that's the art of how do you go somewhere, how do you come back with awareness. And I think this passage from Eliot at the end of his wonderful poem, and I'm going to substitute the word sentence that he has here for the word form, we'll think of it as a form that we do in Tai Chi, and apologies for correcting to you, or changing to you as Eliot. What we call the beginning is often the end, and to make an end is to make a beginning. The end is where we start from, and every phrase and every form that is right, taking its place to support the others. The word neither diffident nor ostentatious, an easy commerce of the old and the new. We shall not cease from exploration, and the end of all our exploring will be to arrive where we started and know the place for the first time, through the unknown remembered gate, when the last of earth left to discover is that which was the beginning. At the source of the longest river, the voice of the hidden waterfall, and the children in the apple tree, not known because not looked for, but heard, half heard, in the stillness between two waves of the sea.